In the 60s, when the movement started, 60s and 70s, in America, drug dealing and prostitution and meat eating were all sky high. So there was one drug dealer whom the cops were chasing. And he was escaping the cops and running helter-skelter, pillar post. And as he was running, he saw on the street a Hare Krishna party, chanting, kirtan party. So he thought, this is a good life-saving mechanism. Just get into them and they will make sure that you don't get out. Because the devotee community, in a transcendental way, is like a mafia. Why? Mafia is a place where you can go on your own. But once you come in, you know so much that you can't leave. They won't let you leave. So we all become devotees on our own accord. We enter the spiritual organization on our own accord. But now that we have learned so much philosophy, even if we desire to go out, we cannot enjoy. Because we say, okay, I'm going to give up bhakti and just watch a movie. You put the TV, dehinosmin yatha dehe kaumaram yovaram jara tatha dehantara praptir dhirastatra namuyati. Next channel. Matra sparshastu kaunteya shitoshna sukha dukkhada aghamapahino nityastam didikshasva bharata. This person switches off the TV and says, let me as well go to the temple. So it's like a mafia. You can come in, but even if you want, you can't leave because Krishna holds you like that. So this drug dealer just entered the Sankirtan party to escape the cops. The cops were running behind him and suddenly they couldn't find him because he disappeared. And there's a Hare Krishna party, dancing Sankirtan party with flags and posters. And as the cops van moved by, because they thought this is not the drug dealer where he is, this is the devotee community. So this person tried to leave the devotion, the Sankirtan. But you know how devotees are. He tried to escape from this side. He said, hey, chant Hare Krishna. He pushed him to another side. So he tried to escape from that side. The devotee said, hey, chant Hare Krishna and be happy. Why you're frowning? Be happy. So he tried escaping from ahead. And the devotee ahead said, hey, chant Hare Krishna. Don't leave. One human form, why you're leaving? So then he was just smothered there. Performing kirtan in that assembly, he reached the temple. Now the cops were a little suspicious. They thought maybe he escaped in. So the cops van, the police van was standing outside the temple. Now this person is in a fix because he entered the temple, he cannot exit. Because if he exits, the cops will catch him. He went and told the temple president, I want to join your temple. The temple president called the lead singer of the Harinam party. And he said, amazing singing. Such pure chanting. People are coming and saying they want to join full time. You should do kirtan every day. And the lead singer felt very good about himself. He said, okay, this is a very good policy. Now this person, drug dealer who entered the temple, he didn't know what he was getting into. He thought he can be comfortable. This is the life of lazy people. That's what he thought. But next morning, 3:30, he was woken up. Hey, jiva jago, jiva jago, Gaura Chandra bole. I'm not saying Gaura Chandra, is saying. A drug dealer is thinking, who's this Gaura Chandra? Wake up, you got to bathe. She thought, okay, this is the custom. He went there. Then there was a big line. Only one bathroom at that time. So 3:30 in the morning, there's a big queue. And he's waiting. He thought it'll be like a very opulent luxury bathroom. Where that's why there's a big queue. So he entered, cold water. In the middle of winter. So he's thinking to himself, where is the heater? And as he's thinking, devotees are knocking, hey! Shri Vigraha Ara Chalu Eudar. The third verse of Guru Ashtaka is going on, come out! So he doesn't know what's happening. He just took two mugs and he came out. He went down. Everybody's standing and staring at some statue. And they forcefully put him a dhoti. He thought, what is this diaper that they have put me? Then he went there. And he was standing. And at that time devotees are saying, Swami step, Swami step. Now he doesn't know what the Swami step is. So he starts looking around and he's swinging and moving his legs at 3:34 in the morning. Then he thought, after this, they'll let me go to sleep. This got over Narasimha Arati. They are keeping a big picture of Narasimha Dev with blood and intestine. So he asked one devotee, what is this? That devotee said, if you don't sing louder, this is what will happen to you. He said, the last devotee didn't sing loudly in our temple, so he's there on the lap on that picture. So you better sing loudly. So this person started singing loudly. Then he thought they'll let him go. After that, everybody starts circumambulating a plant. At 5 o'clock in the morning, what is this? And everybody's walking one after another, after another, after another. Some were doing 11 parikramas also. So he asked someone, how many rounds to do? The devotee said, till the time you don't faint, keep doing. So he continued doing. Then he thought, finally I'll get to sleep. But the actual challenge began after that. The japa time began. So everybody picked up their beads and put it in the bead bag and put one finger out and chanting like this. And wherever he's looking, everybody is doing this. No, it's you, it's you. And he starts thinking, maybe they know that I'm the criminal. I am the drug dealer. It's you, yes, it's you, it's you. Everybody knows it's you. So he asked one person, what is this? And you know, why are they all pointing towards me? And the devotee said, because you're the only one not chanting. They're all pointing, he's the one, he's the one. So you better start chanting. They gave him beads, gave him a bag. Now he thought, chanting on the beads is all too much now. You know, he has no clue what this culture is. So he said, let me do it, but not do it. He kept the beads aside, put his hand into the empty bead bag with his finger coming out. And he also starts walking. No, it's not me, it's you. It's you, and it's you, and it's you, and it's you. And he starts walking with an empty bead bag. Some devotees start saying, how much taste he's having. First day. He's walking. They don't know it's an empty bead bag. And he didn't know for how long this was going to go. 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 45 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours. And then he heard some devotees say, no, 1 more hour left. He said, what is this? He said, no, I'm chanting extra rounds, so 1 more hour I have to chant. So this person got scared. Then he thought, I have to go to sleep now. No, but then the curtains opened. And again, everybody starts, Govinda Madi Purusham. He has no clue what is being sung. And then after that, everybody turns towards Prabhupada's deity and then this loud kirtan. He was thinking, oh my God, all this from 3:30, this is too much. Then he thought I could sleep, and he was right. It was Bhagavatam class. Why are you looking at me like this? So then the Bhagavatam class began and he started falling asleep. The devotee next said, if you fall asleep, no prasad. Whatever we did, you have to do again now. He said, no, better be awake. And he finished all that, then prasadam. Then he was happy. Oh, now after meal, you can go to sleep. Temple president comes to him and he says, this is your kartal and this is your mridanga and these are the books. Go out for 14-hour book distribution. Go out. At least 12 hours you should do. Go at 9 a.m., come back at 9 p.m. Do kirtan all day at the street and give out Bhagavad Gita to everyone. Do this. So he said, 12 hours. He started doing this, started coming back at 9 p.m. Day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4, day 5, day 6. After 6 months, he came to the temple president. He thought, now this is too much. Let me speak the truth to him. He told the temple president, Prabhuji, I am not the person you think I am. The temple president said, wonderful, this is our philosophy. We are not this body, we are spirits. Self-realization in 6 months. I am not what you think I am. Wow, very deep. You are not the body, you are spirit. Amazing. Who's preaching to you? The person said, Prabhuji, your level is too high. I want to be truthful to you. Sir, I'm a drug dealer and this is my story. I wanted to escape the cops and I got into the kirtan and that's how I came to the temple, fearing the cops, and now it's getting too much for me. Temple president said, you're a drug dealer and you're living at the temple? My place is at stake now. Why do you want to be here? The drug dealer said, I want to surrender to Krishna. Temple president said, before surrendering to Krishna, first you surrender to the cops. Surrender to the police. So the temple president called the police came, took him. Then there was a court case on him. They put him on the witness box and started asking him questions. The police came. The judge started asking, so what do you do? He said, I wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning. Then what do you do? I stand in the queue. Then what do? I take a cold water bath with knocks on the door. Then what do? I do the same step for 30 minutes. Then what do? Walk around a plant till I faint. Then what do? I walk with an empty bag without beads for 2 hours. Then what do? I forcefully give up sleep and sit in a boring class. Then what do? I honor prasadam and walk on the street for 12 hours a day. The judge told the cops, chhod do isko. Let him go. Cops said, we have struggled so much to catch him. Why do you want him to go? The judge said, his life is more miserable than the prisoners inside. Inside they're better. He is struggling more. Jaane do bichare ko. He has struggled enough for 6 months. We'll forgive him. So this person came back to the temple, joined the temple, became initiated, and now he is one of our ISKCON leaders. I wouldn't tell you the name. But this personality, when he was giving a class, he himself said a very beautiful realization. He said, what the judge thought was worse than the prison life was actually the perfect life to purify me. And he said, how did I get uplifted? Because I kept myself in power-packed association. I had nowhere to go. If I leave them, the cops will catch me. So out of force, yena kena prakarena, I kept myself in devotee association, and by the spiritual vibrations coming from their side, my consciousness got purified.